Thank you for coming, Iris. Sorry for the short notice.
Should I have brought a gift?
Of course not. Just your phone to document the event and to take notes.
Right here.
Splendid. Now, my guest should be arriving in 5 minutes. If they're timely, why shouldn't they be? I mean, they actually could have arrived anytime they wanted. Unless fashionably late is still a thing.
Professor?
Ah, yes, still in the dark. Well, after 25 years as a quantum physics professor, it dawned on me that I may not live to see the technological fruit of my labor. Spinach puff?
Oh, no thanks.
But at last month's faculty dinner, I was hit with the most ingenious way of confirming my accomplishments.
Oh, an early retirement party?
No, a celebration for those that would benefit from my pioneering efforts. A party for time travelers!
Clever! How did you invite them?
How will I invite them? I have not sent a single invitation.
And you expect them to show up?
At 12 noon, yes. It's on the invitation.
That you haven't sent out?
That I haven't even created. But I will. And I'll send them to the world's finest institutions, and I will document it on the internet. Oh, I've even toyed with the inscription. You are hereby cordially invited to a reception of time travelers, hosted by the esteemed professor, Scott Alistair Lacroix.
Founding father of time travel.
I like that. Write it down. To be held at his residence at 12 p.m. on July 13th, 2019. I'll include the latitude and longitude.
And don't forget the time zone.
Yes, plenty of time for those little details. A month, maybe a year.
What if no one shows up?
Oh, well, as disheartening as that might be, I would have to continue my research. Abandoning it could very well cause a lack of party guests. Please, have a little faith, Iris. Party? It is indeed. And I am the Professor Scott Alistair Lacroix. Please, enjoy our food and drink. Is that shrimp sauce? Yes, it is. Have we overfished the oceans in your time?
No, just couldn't tell.
I'm sorry, I don't mean to come across rude, but in our time, it is customary that we introduce ourselves.
Call me Kent. It's not my real name. I'm not allowed to reveal that.
Oh, yes. I understand completely. We must converse in anonymity for the sake of preventing potential paradoxes.
They said you'd understand.
They? There's a they? Of course there's a they. Probably takes a large group to mount such an effort. Or is it an elite team of carefully vetted scientists and distinguished members of our community?
Yes.
Well, which is it?
It's a large elite group.
So this technology is in the hands of many scientific collectives. I don't know if I'm comfortable with that. I was hoping maybe 3-5 tops.
Oh, it's way more than that.
May I ask you when you came from?
2645.
Oh, 630 years, and your outfit is so vintage.
We have period clothing. We don't want to arouse suspicion that a man from the future is here.
Well, tell your stylist they're a few decades off.
20th century, 21st century, what's the difference?
You don't sound much like a scientist.
Well, over the years, the scientific community decided to ease up on the overly technical jargon. I wanted to be more inclusive for the layperson, but I can assure you, I'm a full-fledged professor, very tenured.
Well, were you able to bring anything back with you, like some sort of proof?
Sorry, they're very strict about preventing paradoxes, but they said my mere presence would be proof enough. I mean, no one from your time could have possibly known that you were throwing this party, and thus anyone who shows up must be from the future.
Yes, I suppose so. I just wish I could get one tiny shred of hard evidence. Excuse me.
Professor? Are you Professor Lacroix?
I am.
Hi, call me Ash. It's not my real name. I come from the year 2967.
Welcome. Have some food. The man at the table is Kent. He's from 2645.
Are those real mushrooms?
Yes.
Man? Thank you.
Hey. Kent, Berkeley quantum enterprises.
Ash, new to Detroit chronography labs. Pleasure to meet you.
I'm not familiar with them.
Well, you wouldn't be. We were founded in 2811 by Dr. Reginald Fallbrook VI. Excuse me.
Great. Dr. Reggie Fallbrook. We had a Dr. Reggie Fallbrook at my lab. I wonder if it's the same guy.
Yes, the exact same. Your Dr. Reggie was actually the third great-grandfather of the founder of the foundation that sent me back here.
Huh. Small world.
Hey, do you mind if I take a picture of this? Okay.
Got it. Thanks, Professor.
Well, excuse me, at the risk of coming across immodest, how much of my work is considered crucial to the creation of time travel?
It's regarded as inspiring.
Mm. Great word, inspiring.
Mm. Well, of my many papers of research and all my formulas that are yet to be created, how much would you say would be essential?
It paved the foundation and laid the groundwork for the many brilliant minds that came after you.
It was off.
Off? How off?
Way off. Especially your paper on dynamic thermal-temporal dissonance.
No, I wrote no such paper.
You will, unfortunately.
Okay, don't let Kent dissuade you. You have to continue your research. And if you don't, it could lead to a diachronic cataclysm.
We call it a chrono breach.
Okay, I guess we do if we're 27th century simpletons, but what do I know?
So my entire life's work amounts to nothing?
No, don't let that dissuade you, okay? The future's not set in stone.
But don't try to change it, because you could kill us all.
Excuse me.
Oh my God. Professor Scott Alistair Lacroix.
You know me.
It's a pleasure to meet you. Call me Weber. Do I know you? Do I know you? Of course I know you. I've been studying you most of my career.
Welcome. Please come in. What year did you travel from?
3254. Although I did stop off in 1926 just to say hello to Herr Einstein. Obviously, he wasn't expecting me like you were. Very clever with the invitation, Professor.
Thank you. Well, we already have Kent from Berkeley.
Kent.
2645. Mm-hmm. And we have Ash from New Detroit.
New Detroit.
2967.
The D. Well, I'm surprised they got here in one piece with such primitive equipment.
They were just telling me that my work barely inspired the real research that led to this technology.
But I think they're seriously underplaying your contribution.
Really?
Professor, your research was crucial in the events that led up to the discoveries of the seeds of practical time travel theory.
Oh, that doesn't sound much better.
Well, I'm actually not a scientist.
So what organization are you with?
Time Travelers of America.
What branch?
Orlando. In the 3100s, Florida becomes one of the most respected states in the United Universe.
So.
It's the back of the throat. It's the back of the
throat. So your organization is not even part of the scientific community?
We are a very enthusiastic and dedicated group of science aficionados.
So no.
And you were able to build a time machine?
I rented it.
Jesus Christ, you can rent them. Rent them like a Corolla.
Yeah, but there's a thorough background check and there's a certified engineer on site at every rental. It's the law. Except on the island of Mexifornia.
Oh, I'm really considering not continuing my research.
It probably won't affect much.
But these stuffed mushrooms are delicious.
Maybe you should become a chef. May I just ask one favor of you guys?
Sure, as long as it doesn't create a diachronic cataclysm.
Chrono breach.
Could you please tell the peoples of your time that this party was a huge success in terms of proving the possibility of time travel?
Consider it done.
Because we already have.
Exactly.
I have a food blog with nearly a billion followers, a small but loyal fan base.
By my time, these stuffed mushrooms are absolutely legendary.
Oh, this party really was not a good idea.
It sure wasn't your worst.
I will write you a glowing recommendation.
Sir?
I'm assuming you're going to want to transfer to a professor whose work actually has some tangible importance to mankind, and it seems inevitable mine shall not.
I know this will sound crazy, but I'm not totally convinced that they are who they say they are.
Do you have a way of disproving their claim?
A password on the invitation.
Yes, they would have to know it.
Even though you haven't chosen one yet.
What should it be?
It doesn't matter. If they're time travelers, they'll all have the same answer.
Yes.
So I appreciate your dedication to the timeline.
Oh, well, they're very strict about that. You just can never be too careful.
But I completely forgot to have you provide your password. The one that was on the invitation.
Here, just write them on these slips of paper, and when you're done, hand them the iris.
Very creative solution, sir.
Right.
Wormhole. Geodesic.
What?
And singularity.
Any explanations?
Maybe we all got different invitations.
Okay, what the hell's going on here? Who are you people? Okay, you won. You got us to break character.
Won what?
What character? We're part of the improv troupe. Say what?
Say what?
You hired us for the time traveler theme party.
Yeah. Hired? What? Why would I hire you? This is a party for actual time travelers.
Wait. Did you really think that we were from the future?
Oh, I knew we nailed it. You nailed it. I know I nailed it.
It was the considerate timeline. That's what sold them.
Yo, we really drove it home.
Oh, absolutely.
Everything you said was not true. My life's work is not a waste of time.
I was supposed to know, not from the future.
Of course, yes. Get out!
Excuse us?
Get out! Drop your drinks and your food and leave!
I thought we were having such a great time.
Okay.
I thought it was fine.
Tough crowd.
Okay.
But look, I've got a couple two-for-one tickets for some A's matinee if you're interested. It just... Okay.
Out!
More fun.
Well, I suppose I can finally concede that time travel to the past is impossible.
That's not conclusive.
Well, then time travelers have better things to do than to spend time with me.
Maybe. Or... It really is too risky for a time traveler to reveal oneself.
Well, either way, I don't believe I'll be sending out those invitations.
But that'll negate this entire experiment. Besides, we don't know how those actors knew the exact time and location of your party.
I suppose their invitations could have been from a time traveler who couldn't risk being at the party in person. They've sent me a sign.
What are you doing?
I'm drafting the invitation. I have to get something down while the experience is still fresh in my head. In 6 months, have these printed in the finest permanent materials you can find.
Consider it done.
And I'll have to come up with a brilliant password. A lot better than wormhole, that's for sure.
I'd be happy to offer up some suggestions. How about faith?
Get it out. Say it.